Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this painting video, we're going to show you how to paint the armour and hair of the Howling Banshees that's seen on the box art. We're going to need to undercoat the model, and in this instance we've used Wraithbone. What this will do will allow us to go straight into the first aspect of this video, which is to use Skeleton Horde mixed in with Contrast Medium and applying that all over the model. So the first thing I need to do is to get some Contrast Medium onto my palette. So I'm looking to do 4 dollops, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, and then just wash off my brush, give it a quick dry, then get some Skeleton Horde and then mix that in, and then rolling my brush to a nice good point and just getting off a little bit of the excess, and then start applying that all over the model, just making sure to keep the paint moving. And if the contrast starts to pool up anywhere, just dry off your brush and soak it up with the bristles. And with that Skeleton Horde now dry, we need to move on to finishing the bone details of the armor. And for this, we're going to be using Wraithbone as a layer just to tidy up all the raised details. And then we're going to use Pallid Witch Flesh as an edge highlight. The first thing we're going to do is get some Wraithbone onto our palette. Like that, a little bit more, and then get some water just to thin it out. And then twisting my brush just to check the consistency, so I just need a little bit more. There we go. And then twisting my brush to a nice thin point. And we're just going to be looking to putting this on all the raised details of the armor, just re-establishing that nice bone effect and leaving the Skeleton Horde in the recesses. With that stage complete, we're now going to move on to edge highlighting. For this, we're going to use Pallid Witch Flesh and pick out all the edges around the model. If you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with Wraithbone. And with that stage complete, we now need to move on to doing the green bits of the armor and the cloth. And for this, we're going to be using Warflesh. We're then going to wash that with non-oil, layer it back up with Warpstone Glow, and finally edge highlight with Moot Green. But the first thing that we need to do is get some Warflesh onto our palette. So what I'm going to do is get a couple of layers of Warflesh onto my palette here. One more. And get some water and just thin that down. And thin down a little bit more. I'm happy with that. And then just start to roll the excess paint off my brush as well as getting it to a nice sharp point. And then I'm going to start applying that over the bits of the helm that need to be green. For this, I'm using a medium layer brush because I just want to control where I'm doing it. If you make a mistake, just tidy up with the previous color. You might need to do a few layers of this just to build up a nice strong base coat. So with that base layer applied, we're now going to apply non-oil all over the green. Now that the non-oil is dry, we're going to layer up the helmet with Warpstone Glow and then just edge highlight all the cloth details with the same color. What this will do is help to establish a difference between the armor and the cloth. With that layer and highlight now done, I'm going to pick out the edges of the helmet using Moot Green. And there we are, with that highlight applied, the green armor is finished. The next thing that we need to do is to move on to doing the hair, and for this I'm going to be base coating it using Squig Orange. I'm then going to wash it using Caraberg Crimson. So what I need to do is get some Squig Orange onto my palette. Get a little bit more. Get a bit of water, wash that down, just get a little bit more water, and start twisting my brush, get the excess off. And what I'm going to do here is just start applying that all over the hair. I'm using a small layer brush here because I still want to be quite neat when I go near that green because I don't want to get any of the Squig Orange onto it. If you do, just tidy up using Warpstone Glow. With that base layer applied, I'm now going to apply Caraberg Crimson all over it. And with that wash applied, we now need to move on to doing the highlights. And for this, we're going to be using Squig Orange as a dry brush just to re-establish that nice color. And then we're going to use Fire Dragon Bright just to pick out the highest and sharpest bits of the hair. So what I need to do is get some Squig Orange onto my paper and just start getting it off as much of the paint as I can. So we just want a little bit left on when we start dry brushing. Yeah, I'm happy with that. And then just gently brushing it up and down on the hair. We're now going to use Fire Dragon Bright as a soft dry brush just over the raised areas. With that second dry brush applied, we're now going to use Fire Dragon Bright again just to add some more definition to the hair. And there we are. With that highlight now finished, the bone, the green, and the hair of the Howling Banshees that we see on the box art is complete. By following this video, you can easily transfer any of the techniques or methods you've just seen to other models in your army. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video, and we hope you enjoy painting your own Howling Banshees, and we look forward to seeing you again soon. Goodbye.